Welcome back to Dandelion! So here, of course, we are back in Dandelion, and we're on Jisoo Route. And we get to choose to go with Jisoo again if we want, so let's go. Let's go to the beach with Jisoo. So, you want to take a romantic walk on the beach again. That can be done. The cool sea breezes make me feel refreshed. Aren't you cold? Hey, being out here makes me think about a lot of things.
Thinking about another girl.
Another girl? Don't tell me you're jealous. Huh, who else would I think of besides you? You're just too cute.
Look around. Yes. Down. Shall. Off we go.
The wind is really something today. I feel like I'm being slapped in the face by the wind. Did you have fun? I always have fun when I'm with you. Let's go somewhere warm.
Has anybody besides me noticed when Jisoo's in the house, his belt is buckled up, but when he's out and about, his belt is open? Has anybody else besides me noticed it? I can't help but notice that his belt is wide open. Let's go do some artwork. I decided to look at some art books. I really like this painting. And my art increased. Yay! Okay, today was January the 29th. I spent the day at the art club room. Jiwoo was still out. I decided to sleep on the sofa for a while. The following morning when I got up, I did the laundry. Jisoo thankfully was indeed in this time. I was getting worried that he wasn't going to be in. I encountered Jisoo. I will save that for like later when we need it, but for now I'm going to save some stuff. Okay, so
can I poke you back again? Hey, let's look at this art book together. This art book is still expensive. I don't know why you buy them. But I'll try to understand.
Okay. Something increased. I don't know what it was, though. I spent the day drawing at the art club room. What is it? Ah! Okay. Pressure! The educational channel. My pressure went down, thankfully. That was like an emergency. Today was probably the first. I didn't get an event yet. Give me an event. Right. I wonder. Jisoo should be fine for now. Let's head to the bathroom actually and try this out here. Some skincare. I think my skin texture has gone worse. I should take better care of it. And my pressure went back up again. Brilliant. Everything I do makes my pressure go up. Oh, today's the 2nd of Feb. And there's an event. Okay, what's the event? Hello? Mom? Oh, great. That's just what I need. I could hear Mom's voice over the phone. It hadn't changed a bit. Yes, Mom. I could only answer yes, as always. Our phone call in half a year ended like that. The phone in my hand suddenly felt very heavy. Mom just said she was coming over to see me. Marvelous. I didn't have a chance to tell her anything about the guys now that are living with me. What would she say if she saw me now? Oh, I have to hide everything. The animals, I had to hide their stuff. I had to make the house appear how Mom expected it to be. I frantically began to gather the animals' belongings all over the house. I have to hide everything. I have to make the place clean.
What are you doing?
When Jisoo saw me stuffing the washer with a bunch of clothes, he looked at me in surprise. What should I do?
You're right, what's wrong?
Jisoo came closer. I unconsciously backed away from him. Jisoo stopped giving me a bewildering look. Mom's coming to visit today. I must hide everything. Mom must not find out. Please, take everyone and go outside. Don't come back until tonight. Jisoo seemed like he wanted to say something, but I ignored him and instead closed the door of the washing machine filled with the clothes. I have to hide all the evidence, the kitchen, bathroom, living room, my room, and the entrance. What the She's like, Jesus. Okay, fine. I hid everything belonging to the animals and I cleaned the entire house from top to bottom. When I was done, I noticed that everyone had gone, thankfully. The house was completely silent. No one is here. I was all alone in the clean house. I could smell the air freshener all over the house. It feels as if I went back to the time when I was living alone. Back to my dull life. I seem to have gone back to the old me when I only showed Mom the door that she wanted to see. Oh no. I took a deep breath. Hell was about to break loose. Do you ever clean up? Yes, actually, Mom. I just cleaned up in a panic because you told me you were coming over. High heels and a designer handbag, nothing about her has changed. Mom looked around the house with a frown. Afraid of her suspecting something, my heart began to beat fast. It's been about 7 months since we met. She hasn't changed a bit. And how I act in front of her hasn't changed a bit either. So you graduate soon, right? What about finding a job? It's been long since I gave up hearing how are you from her. I'm working on it. You should just prepare. You should just prepare. Send your resume here and there. You won't get anything done by saying things. You need to act like everyone else. Mom said as she sat down on the sofa. You're going to graduate from an average school, so you'll probably work at an average company too, I guess. I thought that I was used to those words now, but they still hurt. Average? Mom told me that many times. That I have to be special. Any score lower than 100 is just average. And now I've become that average person Mom always talked about. Mom went out all her ways to make me smarter. Went out of her ways. Not out all her ways, it's out of her ways. What I should have said is Mom went out of her way to make me special. But instead it says Mom went out all her ways to make me special. But I ended up becoming an average person. I invested so much money into your education since you were little. I don't understand why you became like this. Mom opened her purse and took out a small mirror and a lipstick. Mom. I called her in a small voice, but she was more interested in looking at herself through the mirror. Mom. What is it? Once is enough. Mom glanced at me with an annoyed look and began fixing her makeup again. Mom, why did you come here today? Mom, who was applying lipstick, stopped her hand. Why? Are you here to criticize me or are you here to tell me again that I'm not special? I never once regretted moving out of the house. I tried to become that door Mom wanted me to be, but no matter how hard I tried, I could not figure out what I was supposed to do for her. Only anxiety would pile up. Don't talk to me like that! Mom put down the mirror that she was holding. She finally is looking at me. Do you know how much I invested in you? If I hadn't, you'd be worse off than you are now. Mom's angry face. That face scared me to death when I was little. I tried my best not to make her angry, but it didn't work. So I always considered myself as a bad child. I know that you're afraid of, but since you're still my child, I just came over to see how you're doing. A failure? Well, thanks, Mom. Mom still says words that would hurt me so casually. A job doesn't work, just prepare for law school. Why do you always try to push me? There may be something out there that would make me happier, something that suits me better, but why do you always shut out those possibilities and force me to do something I don't want to? I can't even try to seek for what I want to do because I'm a failure. Can't even try to seek for it. Why am I a failure? What? A failure, a success. Who decides that? You're the one who decided that. Did she just? Oh my God, you did, you horrible woman. How dare you? You slapped her. I felt a sharp pain in my left cheek. This is the first time that she hit me since I was little. I don't care, you don't hit people. But I've been hit by her words for too long, so it didn't even hurt. Don't you dare talk to me like that. Are you blaming me for not having a talent? She does indeed have a talent, you horrible woman. And for not working hard enough? No, I'm not blaming you. I'm just trying to tell you to not judge me as a failure. I wanted to say those words, but my voice wouldn't come out of my mouth. I was afraid that I would burst into tears as soon as I started to speak. Do you know how much I invested in you? More than any other mother that I know. Oh, I don't bloody care. But despite what you turned out this way...